And I'd like to welcome our first guests, Kathy Kinney and Bill Burney from the 14th Annual Front Wave Turkey Trot. Welcome.
Thank you.
So I was looking at my card and I made sure I said Front Wave. There seems to be a name change this year, Bill. Can you tell us why that is?
There is a name change, and thanks for asking. We changed our name in November of last year. So what started out with 8 people and $40 in 1952, they created a not member-owned, not-for-profit financial cooperative on Camp Pendleton called Camp Pendleton Federal Credit Union. And over the years, we brought other bases into the fold and whatnot. And in 2002, we said, you know, we need to not just serve the communities on the bases, but serve the communities where they live and the people that support them. So we opened ourselves up to anybody in San Diego, San Bernardino, and Riverside counties. Just recently, we started looking at the name and how it transitions both military communities and the communities that surround them. And we wanted to find a name that would be inclusive of both, that would bridge that difference, so to speak. And we came up with Front Wave. Think about the first wave ashore, right? Innovative, out front, doing those sorts of things. Philanthropy is a big part of who we are, giving back to those communities, which is what attracted us so much to the Oceanside Turkey Trot, because a part of every registrant's dollars goes to one of, I believe, 90 different local credit unions. And over the last 14 years or 13 years, it's been, they've raised over $320,000 for those local charities. We find value in that, and we love being a part of it.
Front Wave Credit Union, 14th annual, I get it. And Kathy, speaking of the Oceanside Turkey Trot, there's also been another little modification. You're not offering the 10K this year. Can you?
Yeah, we took a look at our statistics and we found that our attendance in the longer run was about 1,000 higher when we did a 5 mile rather than the 10K. So we decided apparently the 1,000 people didn't want to run on the pier. So we changed it back to the 5 mile.
Okay.
And we're excited about that. People can still run the 5K, they can run the 5 mile, and they can still do both of them. And of course, we still have the kids 1 mile and 1/5 mile.
Yeah. And you still obviously have all your goodies that you offer and the costuming. The only thing is that you went back to the
5 mile.
The 5K. And also for this year, you have the Move Your Feet Before You Eat Foundation that's a part of this. And you have, what is it called? Miles of Smiles?
Yes. So this year we started a program called Miles of Smiles. And last year with our student lap tracker program that measures the kids' laps at school, we had 2,900 students participate. But they didn't get quite the mileage we were hoping for. And so this year we started out a new program called Miles of Smiles, where we give each student a pair of shoelaces for every increment of 50 miles. Uh-huh. And so if they just do 5 days a week of 1 mile, they should be able to hit it in the fall and in the winter. And so we're very excited about that. We have 6,000 pairs of laces to give away this year, and we're hoping to get rid of all of them.
I'm sure that you will. And getting back to the Move Your Feet Before You Eat Foundation, we spoke a little bit about last month, September was, what is that?
Yeah, Childhood Obesity and Hunger Awareness Month. Mm-hmm. And as everybody knows, obesity is an epidemic in the United States right now. And San Diego County is having its own challenges right now. North County runs at about 40% of the children are overweight or obese, which of course leads to diabetes and cardiovascular disease and many other issues. And long before we worry about the price of insulin, we really need to worry about keeping our kids active and feeding them food that comes out of the ground, first generation food.
And it's so important, Bill, about that concept of that having that foundation supporting, along with Front Wave, the Move Your Feet Before You Eat Foundation.
Absolutely. And we really support the whole importance of physical activity and proper nutrition. And on the flip side, we do a lot to help our members become financially literate as well, because we want to be interested in their financial well-being and their financial futures. So we provide free classes. I think last month we spoke to 7,000 Marines. We had 110 people in one of our branches getting classes on wills and trusts, auto buying, home buying, lots of different things like that. It's a passion of ours.
So not just the physical wellness, but the financial wellness as well.
Correct.
Kathy, Bill, thank you so much for joining us. And we will be right back with more Oceanside Spectrum.